Welcome to this video about some of the supply chain features that became available in 2021 Release Wave 2. Let's dive right in. Add more columns through personalization in various pages. Personalization is a powerful tool for tailoring information on a page. In this release, we've made even more fields and columns available. For example, here's the Get Receipt Lines page with the vendor order, shipment number, and item identifiers. Default line type in sales and purchase documents. Whether you deal with physical goods or use Business Central only for financials, you probably use some type of purchase or sales documents. You can now specify the type of line that you want to use by default on these documents, which will save you a little time on data entry. Add non-inventory items on requisition and planning worksheets. We've added a bit of horsepower to non-inventory types of items by enabling them to be used on requisition and planning worksheets. That lets those engines handle both physical inventory items, such as chairs, and non-inventory items, such as services, in a unified procurement process. Locations for non-inventory items. Something else we've added for non-inventory items is the ability to specify a location for them in supported transactions. The location will be copied to the item ledger, values, and job ledger entries. This is useful for our reports. Item variance on demand forecast. Using item variance is a great way of keeping our list of items under control. We can now forecast demand for item variance in addition to locations and dates. You can manage demand forecast entries directly, or we can speed things up a little by editing the list in Excel. Production BOMs and routes on stockkeeping units in planning scenarios. If we use item variance in demand forecasts, we can now also include them in planning, such as order planning, features for capable to promise, and the requisition and planning worksheets. Rounding for base units of measure. Some businesses buy and sell items in different units of measure, which makes it important to be able to convert alternate units of measure to the base unit. To help ensure that we end up with useful quantities after the conversion, we can specify a rounding precision for quantities. Here's a quick example. We have two lines where we're shipping six chairs, and we define in rounding precisions for one of the items, 1889-S. After we've approved and released the order, we discover that we can only ship four of the six chairs. One workaround is to use fractions to indicate that. When we look at the results, the quantity with a rounding precision defined will be much easier to work with. Unlock timesheets using an assisted setup guide. It's easier than ever to get started with timesheets. The Setup Timesheets Assisted Setup will help us specify the participants in the registration process. The Open Current Timesheet action is available among the self-service activities on our Role Center. The action will take us directly to our latest timesheet in our Open Timesheets page. We can give our timesheet a name that makes it easy to find, and we can quickly spot the unit of measure and the total for our registration. Thanks for watching.